Creating minimalist staircase is extremely easy and straightforward in Revit. In this video, we'll be discussing the details on how to do it and how to have full control over a minimalist spiral staircase. But you can also use it for a straight staircase or any other shape that is minimalist. There are multiple staircase types in the modern and contemporary design, but in this video specifically, we are going to cover open web stairs, how they are going to be done in a spiral way, and as well as stepped stairs. So let's hop onto it. Let's start with the spiral staircase that is open web, but if you stay until the end, I will be also showcasing you how to create minimalist railings. I will be just going onto the architecture tab, circulation panel and stairs. And once I'm there, I will be on the modify tab. I will be able to just full step stair. I will just pick a point and then I will do a radius that's very small, something like this. And if I go in 3D, I will be able to see that my spiral staircase is here and it is created. So let's see how we can play with it. First of all, I would like to remove the support. So I will just finish it. And I will go into the staircase settings. So I will have the railings here and everything, but let's start with the staircase first. So I will just go and edit type in order to remove the supports. I will select none for both supports. I will click apply and okay. So it means that it will remove the support. So you can see that now my riser looks like this and my tread is over here. I want to play with the bed. So I will click on the staircase again. I will go to the edit type. From here, I will select the run type and I will select the three dots on the right edge. What I will do here, I will make sure that I don't have any risers. I want to make an open web and I would like to remove my nosing. So I can leave default and I will just say zero. I can leave those default and I will just click OK. So once I'm done, now you can see that open web is created for my spiral staircase. And if you want the support again, don't worry, you can always bring them back. If you just want the support on one side or both sides, just bring it back, stringer, close, or any other support you are looking for, and you can create it like this. If one support on one side is enough for you, it will be enough to support the entire structure. So let's see if we go with a stepped version, how we are going to create it. So I will remove the support again, just for me to visualize it better, so I can showcase you all the details. And I will go into the run type again. Here I will use 1 inches and then I will do another 1 inches for the riser. And this will allow me to make sure that extend riser behind the tread, join all risers and treads. I can never use this riser profile default, that will be good. And then I will be removing the tread. Now you can see that my stairs are stepped. It's really easy to use and so forth. Now I will showcasing you to do a step spiral stairs, but without a riser and how to do it. So if we want to do it, you just need to go click edit type. Make sure that you first take this note of this riser height and then you go onto the run type. And from here, you remove the riser and you just use exact dimension of the riser for the tread. So if you do that, you will see that it will be stepping and it will be just touching the corners. You can play a lot with the design and as you can see, it's really easy and straightforward. Now, there is a bonus for you. Let's play with the minimalist railings because I know that most of you have issues with the railings. So let's go and see how we can do that. I will remove the internal portion of the railing. I will just focus on the external one and let's see how we can do the minimalist. I want to attach this to a wall, for instance, and I want to make an offset so my hand can grab it so it's not attached up with the edge of the stairs. And I want to make sure that it has a support as well. So let's see how we can do that. I will select my railing. I will go into edit. I will obviously you can do duplicate, but for this exercise, I'll just go straight into it. So I will make sure that I don't have any blusters. So I will make sure that my blusters are none here, none here, none, and none. So I don't want any bluster support. If I apply it, you can see that there are no blusters. So now it's time to add the supports and the left rail. I will even remove the top rail because I need to use a support. So because the top rail is perfectly aligned with the edge, I want to put my hand around the rail and I want it to be offset from the wall, or I would say from the edge of the railing, and the support to be facing exactly on the same plane of the spiral stairs. So if there is a wall or some support, I would like to make sure that the supports are touching that. How do I do that? If I go inside the settings of the handrail, I will be able to choose from here a support, and I will be able to choose a handrail. I want the circular one here in this case. I want to have the offset not that much, I would say 1.25 inches, and I will go to the supports, and I will from here, I will say circular support. I will have a fixed number and I will say 20, and I will just click apply. But before I say apply, I want to say this is staying on the left. So if I click over here, you can see that my top rail is removed and I have my stairs, and these supports are perfectly aligned with the external side of the spiral stairs. Please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, because we are preparing to share with you a lot of great content. We will have BIM talks, we'll have AEC technology products and software reviews, and we will be having a lot of advanced Revit techniques and BIM influence videos. So there are lots of things to share with you and provide you free experience. So hit your notification icon and make sure you don't miss any of the great videos.